Hello again, this is Stan. Have you ever heard the expression, dead tree marketing is dead? Can I say that again? Dead tree marketing is dead. And then may I go from recent wisdom to some very ancient wisdom. Let me say this. Your words must become flesh and bones and bold and bright and bounce. That's what they have to do. Do they? Well, if you want to make your mark in the marketplace today, that's right. Your words must become flesh and bones. The master, the teacher, the entrepreneur said so. We're going to learn a little bit more about that on this Tuesday evening, Wednesday morning, because you're in tune with radio that truly takes you to the edge, radio on the edge. This is the Jesus Entrepreneur, and the learning, the program, the values begin right now. And we're back for about 12 to 15 to 20 minutes. We'll see how it goes on a program which we call Radio on the Edge. That's our production studio, Studio One, the Radio Edge production studio, located in Tucson, Arizona, in the southwestern part of the United States. Cowboy country is often called, and we'll be talking about cowboy entrepreneurs sometime. My name is Stan Husted, and I'm the founder, one of the co-founders of the Christian Entrepreneur Network. We call it the Christian Entrepreneur Project, and the domain name for our new emerging website and stage will be tcenglobal.org. But don't go there now because we're still building it. It's not done yet. We have to make it very special for you. We started over. This is start over season. And so hopefully in just a few more days, we'll be able to give you some more of the help. Right now, we are doing this individual, personal on demand. That's where the word iPod comes from. And that's where the word podcast comes from. Personal on-demand radio broadcast, internet radio at your convenience. We are here whenever you want to hear us, and we do this about four or five times a week as we have something to say. If we don't have something to say, we don't say it. We just let it go that day, and hopefully it'll be helpful to you. We want to help you as you are seeking to make your mark in the marketplace. As a Christian, as an entrepreneur, as a business leader, as a change maker, as a difference maker, somebody who is seeking to be free in building their life and business, and they want to be fully alive. I'm just completing a book, and right now some of my good friends, we have a virtual network, they're in Pakistan, and I believe some of them are working out of Russia and the United States and the Philippines. And we're putting together a little booklet that is simply called Fully Alive, the Prayer and Seven Practices and Principles of the Christian Entrepreneur. And it's just about ready to put on the Kindle and be able to show it to you so that you can take those seven principles, say that prayer, and help your business to go and grow. Coming your way soon, and I hope you'll join us in sharing that with one another and seeding it all around the world. We'd love to hear from you. How can we help you? I have over 40 years, I've been around a long time, in radio and television all around the world. I've been a business performance coach for well over 25 of those years, and there are, I think, hundreds, perhaps even thousands of people who I've been able to help them build their business by learning how to use biblical principles powerful communication practices, how to use the media, the radio, the television, the video, the online work. And with my team of geniuses, you know, if you go to the Apple store, they have the genius bar. Well, we have our own geniuses here on the Christian Entrepreneur Project, and they will be there to help you. Recently, somebody asked a question because they had heard me speak a number of years ago, and they liked that talk, and so they said, Stan, tell us again about the dead trees. Tell us again about the dead trees. So I think I'll take a few minutes to give you a brief summary of that and then kind of introduce you to something else that might be helpful for you today on this second day of the work week, and you'd like to make it even a better week as it goes along. Here we go. There is a part of Holy Scripture, ancient wisdom. It says the Word became flesh. The Word of God became flesh and kind of ran around among us. In fact, as you remember from yesterday, it not only became with us and among us, it literally became one of us. Jesus became one of us. He can look us straight in the eye and say, I know, I was one of you. I lived on planet Earth in the worst of times and the best of times, in the agony and the ecstasy. Whatever you've experienced, I've experienced, perhaps double downed on that. And so I truly understand, and I love you, and I can show you the way to be fully alive and free forever. Isn't that a wonderful word? Forever. Free. Fully alive. Forever. Just let that sit on your heart and mind and head for a while, okay? Well, what the point is that I want you, and this is the reason I do radio and television and a variety of performances, is I want you to know how to make your words, your wisdom, your truth, the stuff that's inside of you that is valuable and helpful and useful to people all around the world, in which you deserve to be compensated for. You deserve it because you're getting value, help, and use, and you want to make your words come alive. You know, as I say, words that have flesh and bones, and they are bold, and they are bright, and they bounce. They move, and they move people. So I'm really going to encourage you to let that little alliteration sit on your head on this Tuesday night and going through the week. How can I make my words when I talk to others, when I seek to prospect, when I seek to attract, when I seek to find new business, how can I make things come alive? The flesh, the bones, the bold, the brightness. Now, one of the projects that my partner and I are involved in is we are helping people really build YouTube channels. Now, if you want to have a business, I'm sorry, your website will probably not be good enough, nor will your Facebook, though it will be helpful. However, what you now need to do, you have to stop writing down on a piece of paper or putting on text in your website or Facebook. You have to stop telling people what you do. They don't care what you do. And they don't care about your degrees. And they don't care about all of those nice things you say about yourself. They want to see and feel and experience how you can help them, how you can be useful to them. And so right now, we're putting together a program where we're going to help you build your very own TV station, your very own YouTube channel, in which all by yourself, with your name on it, and your design on it, and your picture on it, there is a part of the YouTube universe somewhere sitting on their massive servers all around the world. There is a spot just for you. And when you want people to see you, experience you, see you in the flesh, see you kind of bone around, be bold and bright. And remember, it says the feet of those people who bring good news, they have beautiful feet. How can that be? Beautiful feet. That's my challenge to you. Would you like to know how to build a YouTube channel for your business? You have to. I'm sorry. You've got to get with it. If you don't have one, eventually the people who do have one. Even this, I found there's a wonderful guy. He is a landscaper and an irrigation guy, particularly here in, Arizona. Need it to be irrigated, particularly in the desert. And he has his little website, but what he really has is he has some delightful, sometimes funny, teaching, instructing videos, which are just a part of his YouTube channel. And it makes you smile, and you say, that guy's kind of good. And the reason it's good is because it is not a dead tree. Now, what is a dead tree? I just had that dead tree make a sound. That's right. It's a piece of paper sitting in front of me here. It's not original with me, but I borrowed it from a guy who has the same haircut that I do. His name is Seth Godin, and his whole point was, and he said this years ago, a piece of paper, a piece of newspaper, a flyer or a brochure, all of those things are nice and pretty, and they're on paper, but they're obviously made from dead trees. That's what they are. And he said, dead tree marketing is dead. It is. Well, first of all, it really is dead. There is no personality. There's no energy. There is no boldness. There's no brightness of any real kind. You know, you may have bright colors. It may be glossy. But it is words on a piece of paper. And that kind of marketing doesn't cut it anymore. And some of you are saying, but Stan, look at the newspapers. Yeah, look at the newspapers. They're going out of business. I do use the newspapers in one way. Every week, Karen and I sit down and we take the little part of the newspaper that has the food ads in it. And you know what we're looking for? We're looking for the really cheap goodbyes. Great for that. We can find out. Well, there's a sale on milk. Oh, down at the Fry store, they have strawberries for 88 cents. Wow, we better get there. Those are the things they're selling, often at a loss, to try and get me and Karen to come to the store. That dead tree I still look at, but my wife even likes the one that is less than a dead tree. It's the one she gets on her smartphone on the internet because those have even better prices. My point is, in today's world, your business card, your brochure, your flyer, your newspaper ad, it is experientially, personality, energy-wise, dead. It is a dead tree. Are you advertising? Are you spending lots of money for a dead tree? I was at a workshop one time, and I was telling this story, and afterwards a gentleman came up to me and said, Stan, I'm an advisor, and I had a quarter-page ad in a magazine for a certain group, and it ran every month. And it cost me $40,000. And I said, wow. I said, well, how'd it work out? He said, for $40,000 in 1 year, I got nothing. I didn't get one phone call, not one, for the whole $40,000 for 12 months of ads. He certainly said, It was dead. I wish I would have heard this talk before I spent $40,000. I certainly would have spent that money differently. Well, you have no excuse because you just heard this. Here's what I'm simply saying to you. How can I help you? I am not a dead tree. I have personality, energy. There's all kinds of things that in video and radio and in putting those things together, using Powtoons, animation, using the digital internet universe, I can be bold, I can have bones, I can have flesh, and my words can bounce and bright and come bouncing into your life and your place and your space. It is not dead tree. That's the deal. Would you like to know more? My name is Stan. You can call me 520-664-7002 in the United States of America. 520-664-7002, USA. You can go radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com. We'll help you get that YouTube channel going. And we'll show you how using the modern internet media, even perhaps doing your own radio program, your own video station, your own spokesperson video, you will put an end. You will kill off your dead tree marketing because it's already dead. And just as the Bible says, words will become flesh and bones and bright and bold, and be among us. You will be the living word of your message and what you can do to help bring value and good things to the people in the marketplace. And doesn't that sound a whole lot more fun than simply trying to print out and push out and hand out more dead trees? My name is Stan Husted. Wisdom, insight, and truth comes your way from Radio on the Edge. This is the Jesus Entrepreneur, and this is the Christian Entrepreneur Project on the air, just for you. We'll be right back. That's my story, and I'm sticking by it. And by the way, in a few months, we will actually have a course which will be called The 7 Principles That You Need to Know to Market Your Business Today, and They All Come from the Bible. That's right. The 7 Power Principles You Need to Know Today to Market Your Business, and they all come from the Bible. The only book we will use in teaching you how to market yourself and your business will be the Word of God. How about that? Pretty good source. Stay tuned, stay in touch, and be ready to check it out. Again, best and blessings to you. And I want you to hear it, not just read it. Best and blessings to you. May the good Lord be with you and give you His peace, His power, and His presence. Till next time, bye for now.